Hey guys, welcome to Coding After 30. I hope you guys are doing great. In this video, I'm going to talk about what to do if you don't know where to start with projects you should build. Maybe you took one HTML and CSS course. Maybe you've done one JavaScript course. Maybe you even done a React class, but you're still not sure how to come up with ideas of projects and what to build. The truth is, ultimately, your goal is to spend as much time programming, especially if you're just starting out, and basically for the rest of your time being a programmer or web developer, because that's what you get paid for. You get paid for being able to code and being able to create and engineer the projects that you're building, because ultimately that's what your job is. When you're just starting out, it's very hard to come up with ideas. So in this video, I'm going to recommend and show you two courses that I'm taking. And basically, you just find a course that's titled 20 JavaScript projects or 20 React projects, and you go through that. With that being said, you have to understand that doing smaller projects is not going to help you land a job, but what it will do is going to prepare you to be able to make that big cornerstone project that will allow you to stand out on your interview. You have to understand, when you're just starting out and you're looking to switch into web development, especially if you don't have a college degree or even didn't go to bootcamp and self-taught, you have to make sure that the type of portfolio you create competes on the same level with someone that has a four-year degree. They went to school, they did their work. Regardless how their portfolio looks, that piece of paper matters. So if you are going to stand out, you have to show your experience, and you do it with your portfolio. And that portfolio has to be a significant project, which is not a couple of small little projects that you normally do when you're just starting out. But they are important because they teach you and they help you get better at understanding the language and to be able to create that cornerstone project. So with that being said, let's jump into this video. I'm going to share the two of the courses that I recommend, and I'm also going to talk about some of the takeaways that I've done from the course. So let's get to this video. By the way, if you're new to this channel, I talk about switching careers into web development late in life. So if this is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So let's go. Hey guys, here we are again at my computer desktop, and in today's video I'm going to talk about where should you start after you've done your basic HTML class, CSS class, maybe you've done one React class, and now you're looking to start getting some experience in building projects. So a great idea when you can't decide what projects to build is to find a course which is basically titled 20 projects to build for your portfolio, or you could go 20 web projects with vanilla JavaScript. So here you could see I own both of these courses. I have this one, 20 web projects with vanilla JavaScript by Brad Traversy, amazing course and tutorial. And then I also have another class, JavaScript web projects, 20 projects to build for your portfolio by Andre Negoi, or however way you pronounce his name, it doesn't matter. But the point is, you need to spend a lot of time building projects, especially if you're starting out. And if you watch my channel, I talk a lot about having one big project, because honestly, you have to understand, especially if you don't have a CS degree, or maybe even if you want to bootcamp or you're self-taught, you need to have a portfolio that's strong enough to compete with a four-year CS degree. So if you have a bunch of simple projects, and some of these courses do have a lot of the simple projects that I would argue are probably not good for your portfolio, but you have to start somewhere, and what you learn from completing these 20 projects may lead you, by putting them all together, to create one main project. So with that being said, I just want to show you a quick overview of the course that I'm taking, and I'm taking it for a couple of reasons. Number one, I just want to keep practicing vanilla JavaScript. I've been spending so much time with React JS at work that I want to make sure that I keep going to vanilla JavaScript and keeping my skills sharp. Also, I want to be able to take these courses and eventually give you reviews, tell you what I've learned. But ultimately, I also want to go through the projects and not kind of show you what the course is about and teach you everything from the course, because that's what somebody else did. It's their course. I mean, if you want to learn, you should get the course and learn from them. But I do want to talk about my final projects that I've done, go over the code, and maybe pick one or two things to show you so you guys could get an idea. And this will also give you an idea of what kind of things you're going to learn from taking the course. So it's a win-win situation, but ultimately the goal is, if you want to take the course, you get it from the person that created it on Udemy, and I'm just here to kind of showcase what I've been doing and a couple of takeaways that I've got from the course. So let's get started. So in today's class, I'm gonna talk about the JavaScript web projects by Andre Ngoi. And as you could see, he has a lot of interesting projects here. And you could go on Udemy, find his class and watch the introduction where he goes over all the different projects he builds to see if this is something that you wanna do. And so you could get everything on sale, $9.99. By the way, do not buy courses on Udemy for full price. I know you guys know this, but I just want to say that to you guys. So let's see what I've built here. So I've done this random quote generator. So when you hit new quote, it will connect to an API and it would load a new quote. And notice if it takes time or takes forever, the loader will spin and it won't show you the quote until it's loaded. You could also hit this button here and share your quote on Twitter if you're logged in or log in first, whatever, it doesn't matter, but you could share your quote on Twitter. So it's a cool, neat feature. So let's take a look at the code here. In this video, what I want to talk about, and I'm going to do a quick example in CodePen with you guys, is this idea of generally of how would you manipulate the DOM. And what we're going to do, we're going to set up a simple button that when we click, we're able to first display a message in our HTML, but also fire a function that will call and make a request to an API and get a data of a random quote. Now, we're not going to do exactly what this tutorial has shown, right? Because again, I don't want to repeat what somebody else put a lot of hard work and built in a course that they're selling. I'd much rather have you go and buy their course. And by the way, there is no link on the bottom. I want to keep you on YouTube watching my videos. But if you are interested, you know what Udemy is, and you just look up this course and check it out. So again, I'm not promoting this because I get a kickback. I'm promoting this because some of you guys wonder what courses are great, what are we going to learn, and if it helps you to make a decision of following a course. And also, I'm showing that, look, I have these courses online. I have, and I'm going through these courses. So if you decide to buy the same course and you have questions, you could actually reach out to me and I could help you with your tutorials because I have the same tutorial. I've done the same tutorial. And so I feel like where I'm trying to position myself as a coach for beginners will be perfect opportunity and perfect win-win is if I recommend courses for you on Udemy and because I recommended them. And if you get stuck, you could always ask me for questions. So I get to practice teaching, you get to get help, and it's a win-win. Anyway, enough talking. So as you could see, I'm gonna show this simple example here. So I'm going to just pick one example here. I'm gonna pick this get quote button. So as you could see, we're setting a variable as a constant called get quote button. And document.getElementById basically targets an element by an ID in your HTML. And the ID for this element is new quote. So let's see if we could find here. Okay, so as you could see here, we have a button that says button ID new quote. So basically, we are connecting to this button via this code. So now by getting the element by ID, now this variable has this HTML in it and we could do things with it. So in this case, what am I doing in the quote here? So the point is when you press the button new quote, it should generate a new quote. So every time you pass a button, it generates a new quote. So if we go back to here and look at the code, as you could see, let's follow down here. Let's look for a function. Okay, so here I have a function called handle get quote, and basically this fires on a button click in JavaScript. So we have this button, so we can't just tell JavaScript to do something with it if we don't listen to an event on that button. When we click that button, we have to listen for a click event. So I'm gonna go back down here and you're gonna see on the bottom here, I have my event listener. And in particular, we're targeting our get quote button, which is this element here, and we're adding an event listener on click. So whenever you click the button, this handle get quote function is gonna fire. And when this fires, what's gonna happen is going to fire this get quote from API function. And if we go down and we see that get quote from API function, And notice I'm trying to name him in a way where it makes sense. You don't need to learn to code. If you see get quote from API, you know what the function does. So basically what this does, this is going to make a fetch request to our API URL. It's gonna get that data back in a form that we can use. And then we add some simple logic here that basically puts the data into the DOM. But most importantly, what you wanna take away from here is that we have an element in our HTML. We are targeting that element in our JavaScript. We are adding some event listener because this is a button and we want it to do something on click. So we're adding this add event listener on click, and that event listener takes the event and also what we want to do. And I put it in this function called handle get quote. So if we scroll up again, it fires this get handle quote that fires this additional function. I could have just passed this function and not do this, but I wanted to do, if in case I have to do some additional logic in here, that's why I did it. But the point is, the onClick calls a function that does some sort of logic here, which is in this case gets the data from the API. And so basically every time you click the button, it fires that event and it gets that data. So what we're going to do, we're going to go through a simple example in our basic CodePen example. So to start, we're just going to start with a basic div, and what this div is going to have is going to have some text. Now for this tutorial, we're probably not going to get as far as calling an API to make some of this text show up, and let's make it an h1 so it's much easier to see. And what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to increase the size of the window here so you guys could see it much clearer, much better. We're not going to do anything with the CSS, so we could close that here. So we have this area here. We have our H1, which has our text, and it is showing up here. And so what I'm going to do, I want to be able to replace this text on button click. So what I'm going to do, since the div is our container, I'm going to give an ID of container, and I'm going to call it text container. So it's much easier to kind of understand what it is. So once I have this text container, what I need to do is I need to connect it in my JavaScript so we know what we're targeting. So I'm going to create a const here and I'm going to call it text container, which is going to be equal to document.getElementById, and in quotes I'm going to put the name of that ID, which is text container. Now the best thing to do is, if you ever following a tutorial, you're not sure what the instructor is saying, instead of taking my word for it, just Google document get element by ID. So you could go to, you know, Google your trusty resource and do get element by ID, and then whatever shows up you could read. I love the developer mozilla.org, and for beginners the W3 schools is okay too. So you could go here and you could see how they're using it. They have a nice example you could try. They tell you the definition and basically you could kind of learn more about it. And if you want to get even more information, the developer Mozilla or MDN network is pretty good too. As you could see, they show the examples, they show the JavaScript, how it works, and how you could add style to this and change the color, whatever it is, it doesn't matter, but it's a more in-depth way of learning things. So you should be constantly reading the documentation when learning. Don't just rely on the course by itself. So let's come back to here. So now we have document get element by ID, our text container. So what I like to do, and it's redundant, is to console log my text container to make sure that I'm actually connected to it. So if I go into my console, all right, let me make this window bigger here. So as we could see here, we go to our console log and we see our div, which contains our H1 with some text in it. So we know we're connected. So if I were to do text container dot inner HTML equals and put some sort of HTML in here, we should see that that's gonna replace what we had originally. So now you could see that we have hello world, which is a good sign. So now what we were able to do, we were able to select our div and we were able to connect via our JavaScript to the DOM to be able to make changes and to be able to make changes in our DOM. So for now, I'm gonna erase this because we don't need this right now. And I'm gonna erase this console log because we don't need it now. So now we're going to create a button. Let's make a button. And the button is just gonna have click me. So we have an excellent button that says click me. And now when I click the button, nothing happens. So now what we need to do is we need to connect to this button in order so when I click the button, we get some sort of event. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to give an ID here. And for now, we're using IDs because it's simple and it's only a single button that we are, you know, connecting to. So I'm just gonna call this button. And I'm going to go to my JavaScript. I'm gonna type const button. And I'm going to select it using our document.getElementById_selector, and I'm going to say button. And so now our button is connected, but nothing happens when we click it. So this is where we need to add an event listener to our button. So what we're going to do, we're going to target our button through our button variable, and we're going to say add event listener. And what we want to do is we want to pass the type of event, which is click, and we're going to pass a function here. Let's say handle button click. That's what I'm gonna call it now. And that function doesn't exist, so let's create it here. We're gonna create a function called handle button click. And what this function is going to do for now is just going to say alert button clicked. Okay, so now moment of truth. So here we are. We have our button. Our button has an ID of button. We're targeting our button element via its ID, and we're storing it in the button variable. We're taking that button variable and we're adding an add event listener to our button. It takes the type event, which is click. So when I click the button, I want it to fire this function that could have whatever business logic here. And right now it's gonna be an alert. So now if I click the button, look, button has been clicked. So I click it again, button has been clicked. So now we know that our button is connected, has an event listener that's listening for the click. And when we click the button, it fires the function that we created. So now we're going to add logic that will change the text in our div. And we're going to keep it super simple. So what we're going to do is here, we're going to put text container equals, and I'm sorry, inner HTML equals, and we're going to put our message here, which is going to be H1. And the message is going to say, hello everyone, with a smiley face with a tongue sticking out. And then we're going to close our H1. And you could do inner HTML, you could do inner text, there's other things you could do, but for this simple tutorial, this is what we're going to do. So basically, and I'm going to take this alert now that we don't need it, we know it works. So now what's going to happen, every time this button is clicked, is going to replace the text in our text container here to what we posted. So a lot of times, sometimes you're going to have an error, you're not sure what's happening, so let's check it out here. So we have text container is not defined. What does that mean? So basically what that means is that I probably can't type. That's basically what that means. So let's go here and make sure that it's typed correctly. And definitely was a misspelling. The error goes away, it reloads. So now when we hit click me, hello everyone, and whatever type of emoji face this is, I have no idea. So as you could see, we were able to learn a little bit about DOM manipulation with JavaScript and see how you could target your HTML elements via the ID. It's not the only way to do it, but it's the easiest way to do when you're just starting out and learning. And then we set variables to hold those elements that we targeted via getElementById. And in this case, we had one button for which we needed to add an event listener to listen for that button click event. So whenever we hit the button, that's gonna display and show us here. So here's an interesting thing. Let me save this here for a second and let me reload it and try this again. So here we are. Again, we have our initial text that we created. When we click the button, we have our text container, and I gotta fix this here. Okay, our text container is replaced with this message, which is H1 with hello everyone. And so now we see that my button is gone. And so why is the button gone? Let's try to figure out. Well, the reason here is because I made a typo. I forgot to close the tag. So as you could see, when you're programming, a lot of things could go wrong and you need to pay attention. But I hope this simple example helped you to get introduction to simple events in JavaScript, how to target elements with JavaScript. And as you could see, understanding basic DOM manipulation with JavaScript, you're able to create some things. And so with that being said, I'm gonna end this quick video here. And just if you're interested in learning more or don't know where to start with tutorials, the two courses I recommend is JavaScript Web Projects, 20 Projects to Build Your Portfolio by Andre Negwai, however you say it, I'm sorry if I butchered his name, or 20 Web Projects Vanilla JavaScript by Brad Traversy. Now, I know I could make tutorials also, but there's so much stuff already out there online, so I much rather show you the things that I've done and share that with you, and then kind of like I did in this example, go over some of the examples from the course to give you an additional perspective and go from there. So let me know in the comments what you guys think. If you guys have any questions, let me know. And if you ever need any help with anything coding, especially on Udemy courses that you're taking, I guarantee you that whatever course you're taking on Udemy, I have it. And so if you're gonna ask me questions, 100% of the time, I'm gonna know exactly what you talked about if you tell me what the name of the course you're taking or what you're doing. So with that being said, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.